Tonight, Emerald City goes inside Reno Sweeney's Paradise Room for a look at formerly the Harlettes during their closing performance. Also coming up, the Village People singing their latest hit, Macho Man.
Every man wants to be a macho, macho man. We'll have this kind of body.
Good evening. Well, it's a real pleasure to announce that starting tonight, The Emerald City is now aired in San Francisco and will also premiere in two or three other major cities by the summer. I suppose I don't have to tell you what a long road it's been, so I won't. I've got one of the great colds of the season, so I'll make this short. If you have any friends in San Francisco who you might want to tell about this program, we're on out there at the exact same time that we are here in New York. Here we're scheduled at 11 p.m. on Mondays and Thursdays, and there we're on at 8 p.m., but with the zone difference, we're on at the exact same time. Tonight, we'll look at two of the hottest acts in music these days, from Reno Sweeney's Paradise Room, formerly of the Harlettes, during their closing night performance there recently. Diva Dory Hanaway will be talking with Sharon, Ula, and Charlotte about their post-Midler success. After that, another Emerald City exclusive. You saw it first. The Village People singing their latest hit, Macho Man. The number was recorded in a bathhouse for anyone interested. We'll pause for a word from our sponsors and continue from the Emerald City after this. Don't go away.
Just an hour and a half away in Atlantic City, New Jersey, is the most all-inclusive gay complex in the Northeast. The Grand Central Resort features over 175 beautiful rooms, including penthouse suites. And just an elevator ride away, the Showbiz Lounge with spectacular stage shows, the After Dark Piano Bar, Atlantic City's famous M&M Disco, and right on the premises, Club Baths Atlantic City. Right off the boardwalk, the Grand Central Resort in Atlantic City. For reservations, call 609-344-1922. Come on down. The Grand Central Resort is no gamble.
Come to Man's Country. See what we're all about and what we have to offer. Man's Country is a full facility, multi-leveled complex that was designed to feature something for everyone. Come to Man's Country and develop your body or a friendship with somebody else's. Visit us once and you'll come again and again. For the best workout in town, it's Man's Country. 28 West 15th Street.
Metrolines, 24-hour live answering service. Rates are from $5 monthly. Friendly, efficient Metrolines.
Formerly of the Harlettes.
Can't dance to the funky limit. Well, you can't dance at Yay. Tonight we're at Reno Sweeney's. We're surrounded by Harlettes, formerly or otherwise. My name is Dory Hanaway, and I'd like to talk to these girls for just a few minutes, if you don't mind, darling. Let's see. You've sung for many, many different people. I know this is very boring. We've all gone through this before with Merv Griffin, et cetera, et cetera. But you sang for Helen Reddy. You did.
I sang for Helen Reddy, yeah.
You sang for Barry Manilow? No.
We sang for Barry Manilow.
Okay. You sang for Brian Wilson? And I guess you all sang for Bette. She was the one that got you together originally, wasn't she? How does that affect you, the way you perform now? Does she really make a mark on all of you? And do they show?
In a way. She's taught us a lot about stage presence, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Your attitude.
You know, and well, being natural, or just... She allowed a lot of freedom.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So in allowing a lot of freedom, all of the inner elements or artistic things that we have were allowed to come out. So when we're on stage, I don't think we think about that or if we look or sound like that or act like it. I think just that freedom allows all that. True, wonderful creativity.
Yes. You were a superstar in Australia, were you not? You were the Anne Margaret of Australia. No. Didn't you have motorcycles on stage and all that stuff?
Yeah, I did all the commercials.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, I wasn't a motorcycle. I'm not driving it, but riding it.
You gave that all up to become a Harlette?
No, I gave it all up because it was such a racist place. And that was the only reason. I mean, and it was time to come home.
Mm-hmm.
Because it began to be very stagnant for me because of... They don't receive our music until months later, and all of the fashions are ahead of America. Mm-hmm. It's time to come home and rebuild my life.
Do you
life.
Like working in a group rather than being on your own?
Well, I like being on my own, but I also like being in a group too. I mean, it's nice to be able to rest and and let someone else take over.
Yeah. I saw him standing on the corner.
He was very together, brother.
I couldn't keep myself from shouting.
Look up there.
Looky there.
Oh, look at that.
You're the one.
Young girl.
I was in a lot of groups, as a matter of fact, rock groups. I was always like the lead female singer in my neighborhood.
Oh, yeah.
And David Lasley's group, Valentine.
He's the one that wrote Roll Me Through the Rushes.
And, you know, I was in up front.
Mm-hmm.
Lounge now, acts.
Besides being a champion ice skater, Ula,
yeah,
how does it feel?
I'm
a champion
ice
skater. Oh, you are?
Yeah, that's not swimmer, too.
Swimmer?
Yes.
Do you float?
I float. I'm trying to be Esther Williams.
Oh,
I'm trying
really?
To bring back the aquacade, you know, the synchronized swimming, you know, where the women never get their hair wet. They're always smiling.
Yeah, I got it.
The first tour when I got with you all with that.
Yeah.
Everybody
got in the pool
and they had this sort of musical thing going. And Charlotte was the
the head person. Yeah.
Okay, everybody on their backs. Hey.
Charlotte, you're so tasteful off stage. How do you manage to become such trash when you get on in front of those lights? I mean, you really are.
I think a lot of it has to do with the people that come to see us, you know.
Mm-hmm.
If there are any freaks out there, that they, you know, they sort of bring out the freak in me, you know what I mean? They really sort of feed the flame.
Mm-hmm.
I was telling a friend of mine tonight that I felt like there was I was the burning bush.
Oh, darling.
No. That I was like, there was this perpetual flame that was like, you know, that was like constantly having, you know, kindling thrown on it, you know, and it affected all of us, you know, because I really feel like we're really burning, you know.
Oh, I met my lover man on Christmas morning. We finally tied the knot on New Year's Eve. Groundhog Day was the first day that I touched him. And Valentine's the day that I conceived. Labor Day is the day we had our baby. But he began to drink on Yom Kippur. Halloween, he stayed out trick-or-treating. But Thanksgiving's the day that he walked out the door. Teardrops on my turkey, I'm weeping in my yams. The grave is getting murky, but you don't give a damn. Liquid mashed potatoes, I'm crying in my soup. Soggy stewed tomatoes, my lover's flown the coop. My stomach growling from below. But stuffing's all I have to put inside me. And turkey legs are all I have to hold. I got lots of pink feet and lots of black-eyed peas. Loaves and loaves of cornbread with a slice of hoghead cheese. But I ain't got no lover, no, I ain't got no man. Some home fries and an empty can of Spam. Teardrops on my turkey, I'm weeping in my yam. The grave is getting murky, but you don't give a damn. Liquid mashed potatoes, I'm crying in my soup. Soggy stewed tomatoes, my lover's flown the coop. Teardrops on my turkey, my lover's flown the coop.
Thank you, John Tolo, baby, wherever you are. Buonasera, buonasera.
Instant transformation, hey. You are the oldest living Harlette,
yes.
Are you not?
Yes, I am.
What would
then I retire?
Bumped from the tour, as it were,
really?
By your own group now. What was your most exciting experience when you worked with Bette?
I think my most exciting experience when I worked with Bette was when we were at the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion in 1973.
Mm-hmm.
I think Sharon was in the group then, and Robin Grion was our resident white girl.
Oh.
And there were two experiences. One in 73 when David Bowie and Claudia Lanier were sitting in the front row center of the Dorothy Chandler. We were doing our encores, and they were the only people who did not stand up.
Ooh.
Now, that wasn't a thrilling experience for me, but that stands out in my mind as one of the most cheesy experiences. Because then we got to know David and everything. And the other great experience was that the Dorothy Chandler in 1976, 76 when we did. Yes,
that
was New Year's. Right. New Year's of 75, that year when we were at the Dorothy Chandler, and Laurence Olivier came back to see us, and I'd never met him before, and I was just so moved, and there's pictures to show Sharon and I sitting with him. He was just like,
oh, he's
so moved, you know, like he's like the big divo, you know. He's like, he's done everything. He's married to the great, the new great, and the dead hate.
Oh, dear. Tasteless. Well, let me talk to you a minute about the material that you do. I noticed you do something of
cotton.
Marshes.
Yes, marshmallow.
Where do you find the other material that you work on?
We all just go through the steps. We go through, first of all, we have a lot of friends that are songwriters. Allie Willis, David Lasley, Marsha Malamud, Jerry Ragavoy. Yeah.
A lot of people.
That's the great thing about being a New York resident.
Sure.
Everyone sits at home and writes.
Yeah. And they all say, well, listen, I got this song. It's like Tin Pan Alley in a way, you know. It's like a melting pot, you know.
Right.
I mean, it's more intense and it's so much more... It's just so much more together here than it is anywhere else, I think. And everybody gets their start here. I mean, if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.
Right. The material is—it's not so much that they're friends of ours; it's that the material is great as stuff, which is always helps.
I remember the night when my poor baby died. Her mama cried, cradle me. Her baby left me all alone. Her papa gave us no home. Oh, I cried in the night. Like a baby full of fright. Where is my old man now? Hey, mama, my mama was right. Ain't no man worth it.
No man.
Ain't no man worth it.
Ain't no man worth it. Mama was right, she said. Ain't no man worth it. No. Mama was right, she said.
No tears in a romance's eyes. Papa's just like all the rest who are making me their quest. They want a daughter 5 years old. They want a mother wise and bold. Now tell me, why can't I be a wife? I just want to be a blah, blah, blah. Hey, mama, my mama was right. Ain't no man worth it. No.
I like the idea of giving new writers a chance, you know. Most superstars, I find, always use other superstars' songs when they record their record, when they're putting their record together. And I'm a believer of young, fresh, new material.
Mm-hmm.
And if they happen to be your friends, great, you know. But I like unknowns, you know, and because we were unknowns. Why not continue supporting
the unknown?
Yeah.
Well, where do you go from here now?
San Francisco. San Francisco.
You're going on tour with this new record?
Yeah.
Are you going to record again?
Plans for our second album probably in August or July or something like that.
As soon as we finish this tour,
So if any of you out there have any material, send it in. We give all new writers a chance.
Silk, raw silk, polyester.
They'll take anything, apparently. This is Emerald City. And good night from the Harlettes. Formerly the Harlettes. See y'all soon. See y'all soon. Hot trash. Hot trash. We got hot trash.
Currently me on the banks, near
cups and golden plates. I'm well prepared for my last journey. You know I've worked all my life to make this basket strong. But a soul all alone in a basket.
You may find it difficult locating Jan Wallman's, but the best things in life aren't always easy to find. Jan Wallman's, 28 Cornelia Street, where 6th Avenue meets West 4th. Jan Wallman's, fine food in a fine setting.
Now is the time to visit the world's largest emporium of erotica. Come, experience New York's most extensive selection of adult magazines, films, and paperbacks. 250 Book Center and GNA Books. No matter what you're seeing, if it's the finest in visuals you're after, we've got it all. Two locations in Manhattan. 250 Book Center at 250 West 42nd Street. GNA Bookstore located at 251 West 42nd Street. Come on over. You never know who you might bump into.
This is their home and this is their style, the Village People.
Thank you.
From Casablanca, the Village People's new album, Macho Man, is now available at record stores everywhere. Get it, it's hot.
Think it takes years to get a great body? Think again. Profile Fitness Center can change your profile in months. Have you looking great this summer? Profile has it all, the finest facilities in New York, including the latest Nautilus equipment, expert instruction, and friendly clientele. After your workout, relax in the steam room, sauna, whirlpool, or TV lounge. Profile at 47th Street and 2nd Avenue is open 7 days a week. So get the body you've always wanted at Profile. Call now and get the summer free.
Special thanks to Russell Sadelsky of Can't Stop Productions and also to Candy Lee. And thank you, Walter Kent of the Beacon Bats, for your continued support.